I just finished my first masterclass here in Mumbai. The energy was through the roof. Like, I'm so excited. The dancers are working so hard. Everybody's sweating. I had, like, so I can't wait to get back on the floor and dance again. I had so much fun.
Who inspires you to do dancing and this kind of masterclass?
Well, actually, my mom was the one that kind of put me in dancing school, and then my parents both really pushed for me to be a dancer, and they're kind of the ones that always inspire me and support me and push me towards, like, whatever goal I have in mind, and doing this and teaching for this many amazing dancers in a place like Mumbai is honestly beyond my wildest dreams, and it's so, so incredibly, like, awesome. There's no other words.
One thing you really like India.
One thing I love about India? Oh, there's more than one thing I love about India, but my favorite experiences in India have been with the dancers, and I feel so privileged to be here, not only to experience the culture and the food and the relationships and the friendships that I've made, but to actually be able to interact with dancers here and see that their level is so high, but more importantly, that their passion for dance is, like, maybe the highest I've ever seen anywhere, and it's so inspiring.
So how's going your show, like, with Lara? High Fever, how's it going? How's the experience?
High Fever is probably the best experience I've had in my professional career. I've never done anything like this. I've never actually been a judge on a reality show. I've been a judge for dance competitions before, but never in a reality TV setting. So I didn't really know what to expect coming into it, especially being somewhere completely different. But it's just exceeded all my expectations. Like I said, the contestants are not only incredible dancers that are skilled in all styles, from contemporary to hip-hop to Indian classical styles, they're actually inspirational people who have gone through crazy hardships and have really inspirational relationships and have beaten all kinds of odds and broken boundaries to be on the stage and be dancing. So it's such an inspiration for people to just follow your dreams and do what you love to do, and I'm loving the experience.
It is difficult to judge like a dancer or something.
Actually, it's a little difficult to judge because especially as the competition goes on, you fall in love with the contestants and you, like, don't want to see any of them go. But I do have a lot of experience in dance, and I've got like 25 years of technical training and a lot of styles under my belt. So I do have a really critical eye, and I find that it's not easy to judge, but it's easy to offer constructive criticism and to find the places where people can always improve, because that's what dance is. Like, you can always be getting better. So I have mentors that do that for me, and now I have the privilege of doing that here for the contestants on the show.
Anything you want to say about the organizers of this session?
Yes, I really appreciate Events Maniac. This is the second workshop that they've held for me, and it's honestly always an amazing, last time was an amazing turnout, and this time I think even blew the roof off that. So it's always a great experience working with them, and it's easy, flawless, super fun.
And who is your inspiration?
My parents are my inspiration. Yeah, my parents inspire me in everything I do. They've both overcome so many difficult things, and I'm an only child, and they worked their whole lives to just make the world available to me, and I would not be where I am if it wasn't for them pushing me and inspiring me every day.
Dana, and any dream you want to fulfill in future as a choreographer or anyone you want to work with?
You know, it's kind of funny because I don't have the typical dream where it's like, oh, there's just one person I really want to work with, or there's one thing I really want to accomplish. My overall dream was to be a dancer, but to be myself, to be able to connect with other people as myself. I didn't always really want to be a backup dancer or do some of those traditional jobs like go on tours. I wanted to have a voice and be able to interact with young dancers and inspire them to chase their dreams and to really go hard at everything in a positive way. I wanted to be that mentor that I never had. So this is my dream, and honestly, it overwhelms me that the things, the experiences I have are greater than anything I could dream or imagine for myself, and they're so fulfilling, and I'm just excited to follow this path and see where it goes.
Favorite dancer in India?
Favorite dancer in India? Oh, it's so hard. I love Tiger Shroff now. Okay. I love him. But I think, Gary, what's that other dancer I love? Ruthik, right? Is that who? Riddick?
Riddick Roshan.
Riddick Roshan, that's who I love. I can't say his name. Sorry, Riddick. Love you. You're so good. Yeah, he's my favorite.
Diana, would you like to describe one line into the Bollywood?
Sure. What, baby? What now?
One line.
Describe Bollywood in one Bollywood. Word.
Bollywood in one word.
Yeah. What would you like to say?
Look the
center.
Maybe magnificent.
Yeah, yeah.
Magnificent. That's the biggest word I could think of. I love Bollywood culture, and watching the dancers, especially doing Bollywood styles on the show, has been like mind-blowing. They are just so incredibly big, and their personalities are big, and their talent is so big. It's explosive. It's electric. I would love, I mean, that would be an amazing experience to get into Bollywood somehow and dance and choreograph for something. That would be awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you guys. Appreciate you.